I'm William Boylan. For half a century, I was pastor here at the Byfield Parish Church. I'm still here in a certain capacity of pastor emeritus. Halfway through that half century, we built this building, and in 1988, dedicated it. Probably there's many people who worship here today who do not know that there was a cornerstone placed in the building with the date on it, 1988. It was quite a day for us. We had a ceremony. Marilyn Shepherd, who sang in our choir, but also in one of the trio, sang, "Jesus is the cornerstone." And it was really more than just an event. It was rather emotional because God had provided for this building in the most remarkable ways. This church's edifice cost $2 million, and yet the congregation that prayed and worked and labored for this building was only about 250 people at the time, 250 in attendance. And that was quite a feat, and it was an impossible feat for those that were here. Actually, it was God's provision, but it was remarkable in the way He provided. Not only is this cornerstone probably not seen by many as it's a little bit hidden now, but there's something that no one can see, and that is within this foundation is a time capsule that was placed here in 1988. Been here almost the length of time that a generation in the Bible lasts, about 40 years. It's been here 32 years. And we trust that when this building either comes down or someone makes the effort to find that capsule, we hope that they will be very much encouraged by the kind of things that happened when God was building this church and creating the need for such a large building here toward the end of the 20th century. So with all that in mind, I want to tell you one aspect of this that probably very few except me know. And that is that this is the fifth meeting house. This is the fifth building in which the Byfield Parish Church has met. Now that's no secret. But what is interesting is there are only two buildings that were used for worship that were built because the congregation expanded to the point that the old building couldn't accommodate for everyone. And that was the first pastor of the Byfield Parish Church, who under whom the church grew and developed. Now, it was not mysterious. It was the time of the first great American awakening. And by the time Reverend Moses Hale, who was that first pastor, came to the end of his ministry, they had to build another meeting house because of the overflow, because there just wasn't room for the numbers who wanted to worship. And that was in 1746. That building that they built lasted about 90 years, and in 1833, fire took that building and the meeting house burned down. They erected a new meeting house, and that meeting house stood again most of a century, and in 1930, lightning struck it and it burned down. That was the meeting house to which I was called when I was brought on board to be the preacher. And it was about 20 years into my pastoral ministry that we outgrew that church, that building, that meeting house. And so we voted, after we had prayed and really sought the Lord's mind, we voted to build a new structure that would house everyone. Now, that's interesting to me on a number of levels, but let me just say one of them. So the first pastor of this church and me both experienced such growth that a new meeting house was needed. Interesting that first pastor back in 1702, that's when he came on board and ordained in those days, the first pastor of this church is my fifth cousin, eight generations ago. And the church under him grew to that point where they needed to build again. And here I am, eight generations later, his cousin, and the church so grew under me that we had to build again. You can make of it what you want. As for me, it's just very encouraging. I'm going to take it as a sign that God doesn't forget His promises, that He keeps them, and that this building is not so much a credit to me, certainly, or even the members of the church. It's a credit to the grace of God who keeps His word who builds his church, and you can trust, if you trust your life to him, that you will never ultimately die.